Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. I'm Tracy, and if you don't know me, I have a passion for upcycling clothing and I teach sewing on here. I'm back in sunny California, so I'm actually teaching a sewing camp with my old sewing teacher next week, so that's really exciting. I'm probably gonna just take like a break. I just wanna thank everyone for like all of the support. I've gotten like an overwhelming amount of messages regarding the viral silk dresses I made. I promise I'll be doing a made to order drop soon. I just don't know when. I just have a lot going on right now in my personal life. For this week's video, I ended up thrifting a lot of vintage silk scarves, so I decided to do another silk scarf tutorial for you guys. I'm going to be teaching you guys how to make this silk halter top. It's so easy. This is very beginner friendly. All of the tops will be available on my Etsy with a matching scrunchie. The materials needed for this project are just your basic sewing supplies, a sewing machine and stuff, and just a scarf. So your scarf can be about like any size pretty much, but I recommend using like about a 45 by 45 inch scarf. I did a double layer because I'm using a silk chiffon and it's kind of sheer as you can see, but I like placed it in a way so I get the most coverage. You're welcome to use any woven fabric for this project. I definitely recommend using silk just because it'll lay really nice. I also wanted to announce that I am releasing my first plus size sewing pattern. I actually had somebody try it out for me, which was very exciting. I have the Milkmaid sewing pattern now available on my Etsy in 38 double D. I'm very new to pattern making and grading. I am working on being more size inclusive, so just be patient with me. I hope you guys enjoy this tutorial, so please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe.
I thrifted this scarf like I did with all the other tops, and this one was about 60 by 60 inches, so it was pretty big. I was able to make two tops out of this, and you wanted to start by like slashing and tearing off the hems off of the scarf. So I'm just cutting about like an inch and a half away from the hem and just tearing into strips. And these strips are going to be used later to make the straps. And now that we ended up with a square that isn't hemmed, I'm just taking my tape measure and just measuring out 15 inches from one corner and cutting at that point, and then just tearing all the way down the scarf. And I'm going to end up with two squares that are 15 by 15 inches. And since I was working with a silk chiffon scarf, as you can see, it's like very see-through, so I decided to do two layers. That's why I ended up using two 15 by 15 inch squares, but if you have an opaque fabric, you can only do one. There was so much of the scarf left over, so I was able to cut out a 20 by 20 inch square and do this silk cowl top. I will link the tutorial. I made a tutorial on this top previously. Back to the silk halter top. So you're just gonna take your 15 by 15 inch squares, and again, I'm doubling mine because it's so sheer. And my silk fabric has this floral print on it of like cherry blossoms. So I'm kind of just placing these flowers right on top of each other so that when it's on my body, it's like covering my bust. And it's very important to press your fabric before sewing it. I start by pinning both layers together, and I'm just going to take it to my overlock machine to sew them together so it can act like one piece of fabric instead of two, if that makes sense. So I'm just like sewing all the way around the perimeter of the square. And if you don't have an overlock machine, you can feel free to just like do a quarter inch stitch and then do like a zigzag if you want to like finish it, but it's not necessary. You can just do the quarter inch stitch all the way around the scarf. Now it's one piece of fabric, and you can just take your scissors and just trim off that excess thread. And now to hem the top, you can just decide what side you want to be the front and what side you want to be the back. So you're just going to do the double fold towards the inside of the scarf. So you're folding a quarter inch once and a quarter inch twice and just placing a pin. And you can feel free to just like baste the whole hem if it makes it easier, because I know it's like a lot of pins and it's kind of annoying to take it to the sewing machine and try to sew silk chiffon this way. So I recommend using a silk needle, but then you're just going to do a top stitch all the way around the perimeter. I like to see the inside of the hem as I sew, just so I can sew like as close as possible to that fold of the hem. Once the top is hemmed, we can proceed to do the like channel that the straps are going to feed through on this silk halter. So you're gonna just like look at your piece of fabric in a diamond shape, because that's how it's gonna be on the body. So you're gonna just take the two sides and you're just gonna fold once a half inch and then fold again a half inch. So you're gonna end up with this like half inch tunnel, and you're just pinning that in place, and you're gonna repeat it to the other side and take it to the sewing machine and just stitch as close as possible to the inside edge. And with the top corner at the very top, you're going to just fold that down a half inch, and that's just gonna be the tunnel for the top of the halter. I take it to the sewing machine and just top stitch those tunnels in place. And I'm just taking those strips we set aside when we tore off those hems, and I'm just sewing them all together into one long piece of spaghetti. And I'm just taking it to my overlock machine and folding right sides together and sewing a quarter inch spaghetti all the way down. If you don't have an overlock machine, you can just use your regular sewing machine and do a zigzag stitch or an overlock casting stitch if you have it on your home sewing machine. I'm just taking a safety pin and pinning it to the end of the seam allowance and just like putting it into that tunnel and just like doing this push and pull method to turn this spaghetti right side out. And now that my spaghetti is done, I think it ended up being about like 2 yards long finished. So I'm just leaving the safety pin on one end and just feeding it through the top channel first. And then I'm just like crossing both straps and feeding it through the opposite side of each, if that makes sense, and just like feeding it through the tunnel. So you end up with like this cross back instead. To clean finish the ends of your spaghetti, I like to just knot mine because it's easier, but you can also just do like a double fold and do a hand stitch to just keep it really nice and clean. I had enough scraps to make scrunchies for all of these, so I'll just link a scrunchie tutorial down below. I love how they turned out. Thank you guys so much for watching.